Tom.
Yes.
Tom was a great man for music, that's what I remember. But I remember him from a long time before. With Tom and myself, if we were talking privately, it was all about music, naturally enough. And the youngsters were always brought into it. Because they had an interest in himself. He knew they had. They got two stools, they had two stools for the... There's one of them, it's there. To sit on when they come in, you see. Lower stools. So that was part of the regulation.
Age.
She that seemed to take up with the music, but she was good on the banjo before she took the fiddle at all.
But she was, I knew that she was set at picking them up. Any tune you played, she'd have them picked up while you'd be winking.
There was I was never regarding myself as a composer. And I made up a tune in Paddy Paddy's, for Paddy Paddy, just to see what would you think of me. And he was pushing with it ever since. That's the one she plays now. It pushes Paddy Paddy. He's not able to play, whatever it's called that, I don't know. But I'd say, it pushes others as well, but maybe it might push the good players, say. So, because that was Paddy Paddy that just put the idea into my head of composing the tune. And I composed a good tune. But, and matter of fact, John Carlos was in here a week ago and he asked me, could I do a tune specially for him? And I didn't think of anything. That you could do this, the like a tune, or unlike a tune. You want to have it as much as you could outlandish. That it shouldn't be, you couldn't say that there was another tune involved. Because if you had, you'd have a mess made of it. Paddy Paddy was the most influence that they had on me anyway, from listening to him. And every time I go up to the house, he'd have a new tune for me. And he used to have 70 or 80 between all. He never was shy about handing them out. If you were able to play it, you could play it. So Tom, or the father, used to like particular tunes, especially there was that tune that the Lonesome Fiddler that she puts on there, and she does a powerful job on it, doesn't she? Well, the Lonesome Fiddler, the first one that put that on play was Joe Burke's wife of the time. She put it on and she asked me on the phone what did I think of it. I said it was grand enough. It was nice enough, but I said she had one important note was wrong. And she said that wouldn't make much difference. And I said it makes a difference in this tune, because there was a certain ear that you have to get into it. If you didn't get the notes right, then you hadn't the thing right at all. So I thought, I don't know whether she was happy or not, that, or what she done with it. But she put it on tape anyway, and it didn't sound right on the tape.
The Meelic team was a team that won they didn't win the All-Ireland, but they played Tipperary in the final of the All-Ireland. That was, at that time, it was a parochial team. They got up a team between the whole lot of them, and they won out the county and they won the provincial. And they came to the All-Ireland, they had to play Wexford in the semi-final and could best Wexford, and they got the next team they had to meet Tipperary. And that was their downfall there. They went down, Tipperary were good that time, you see. Oh yes, that was the Meelic team. In the 60s, Meelic lads got together again, and there was a good crowd of young lads. And they got to get a good old team together again. And they won the county, I think, which was the only thing you could win at the time, it was. There was a tune made up for in memory of the team, but I never knew it. And then I said I'd make up a tune in memory of the 60s team. Well, then they say that no Paddy Fay later on, after I did the leaving search on that, when I started going round and searching round to see what would I hear. So I knew about the Arkham Slopes, of course, before that altogether. I didn't know who the personnel were, if you like. I didn't know the people, the Paddy Fahey and the Paddy Kelly, and they were the great musicians of the Arkham Slopes. And there was whatever, there be six of them altogether, I suppose. I wouldn't be able to tell you their names now off the cuff. But I got to be a great friend of Paddy Fahey's over going to see him, and I didn't realise that he was such a good musician for a while. But he had a master stroke, right?
Yeah.
He was a playwright and slow. But he wasn't like any musician you ever heard. Because he could invent a tune in a second. Like he had that kind of a thing. And that became a hairful. And that was Paddy Kelly. Paddy Kelly was a great character. I never heard him only once. He was twice when he was in. He used to come to Paddy Kelly, especially when I'd be there, because he used to come for a tune. And because he plays well, and by Jesus, I'm telling you, he could play. He was a master stroke. He's a great old character to sit down. He'd have stuff from back. He wished he'd learned it when he was young, that late. Lennigan's Ball and all this stuff. He had veterans there, and to make your cat laugh to hear about it, you know, the way he could bring it out. So Fahey has proved himself ever since. They came talking about 50 years ago now. And so Fahey has proved himself to be the greatest since that. They've got nothing like him, like under the want. And he's 96 years of age now, I think. And he's great imagination, right? He could invent the tunes. And every time he comes down, he'd have a new one. He'd have a ready and all for you, and, you know. And you'd be sorry that anything could ever happen. That's for only why he'd have to die, like, eventually. Well, what would it be like? It'd be a sad day for me anyway when he dies.
Ailish, I think you were the best player ever I had Andy to do it anyway. And it all comes out in the music now. And I don't hear anyone that can play like you're as good as you, really the same way. And that's important, what I think. That you have to take your time and phrase it out properly. That's the way I take it to be played, so. I hear some of the tunes that you put on the record, right? And they're beautiful, lovely. I never thought you were as good. I didn't really. It was outstanding, like, the whole lot.